538 वर्स विवेक चुड़ामणि। चिंता शून्यम अदैन्यम अभैक्षम अशनम पानम सरिद वारिषु स्वातंत्रेण निरंकुशा स्थिति अभी निद्रा श्मशाने वने वस्त्रम क्षालन शोषणादि रहितम दिग्वास्तु शय्या महि संचारो निगमांत वीथिषु विदाम क्रीड़ा परे ब्रह्मणि। सो पीपल who have realized Brahman or realized the ultimate reality, they eat without chinta shunyam, without worries, adainyam, and also they don't be they are not humiliated. Adainyam. They eat without, they have their food without worries. So when people eat, they worry, they think of so many things. There is this famous story about a Zen master and his student. So Zen master was there and a student went to the Zen master and asked, please show me the way. Means show me how to realize or know the truth, etc. And then the Zen master said, it is simple. Eat while you eat, drink while you drink, walk while you walk, sleep while you sleep. So this student said, already I am doing the same thing. What is so great about this? He said, no, you think while you eat. You worry while you drink. Your mind wanders when you walk. And you dream while you sleep. So you don't do these things. So you do these things. Whenever, whatever you are doing, you do only that. So here, this is a wonderful shloka where a sannyasin, a person who is vidam, means a person who has realized ultimate reality, and that person is Krida Pare Brahmani. That person's entertainment or leisure is Supreme Brahman. That person's pastime is Supreme Brahman. What does that person do or these people do? Chinta Shunyam Adainyam Abhaiksham. They have their food without any worry or without any humiliation by begging. So even if they beg, they are not humiliated by that. They don't feel that they have no respect, etc. And Sarid Varishu Panam, they drink water from wherever they get. Other person will go for reverse osmosis water, extra filter. See, reverse osmosis, I don't know how it helps. But they say, this so much scientific, this thing, reverse osmosis. People, we all grew up drinking ordinary water. Nothing happened to us. Now reverse osmosis. Now people who will drink this water, what immunity will they have? Will they have any immunity? No immunity they will have. So reverse osmosis, that, this, etc. So this person who is dependent on God, that person drinks from Sarid Varishu, means from the water of rivers. Swatantriyena Nirankusha Stitihi, and lives freely. Swatantriyena and Nirankusha, independently, without any dependence on anybody, only depending on God. And Abhihi Nidra, and sleeps without fear. That means that person sleeps in any place and does not fear whether tiger will come, whether leopard will come, what will happen, will somebody come and rob me. So there is nothing to be robbed. There are no possessions. So that person is not afraid also. And smashane vane, that person's without fear, that person sleeps in smashane, in cremation grounds and in forests. That person is not afraid of ghosts also, or not afraid of any wild animals also. Vastram kshalana shoshanadi rahitam digvastu. And their clothes will be how? The clothes will be directions. Directions are clothes. We have four directions or eight directions, whatever the case may be. They are all clothes for them. That means they don't wear any clothes in the nude. Naked they can roam. That is why in Jain monasticism you have Shweta Ambara, Digambara. Shweta Ambara means clothing, Ambara. Shweta means white clothing. And Digambara means for whom direction itself is clothing. That means the person is wearing nothing. The person is wearing nothing. So they go without wearing anything. You know, in earlier days, sadhus were not wearing any clothes. They had no screens, no curtains, and they used to roam about freely. Now, and outside people, means other people, people in society, they used to live in close quarters, they used to cover themselves, etc. Now it is quite the opposite. Now they don't cover themselves, they roam about in the open, almost nude. They roam, and sadhus have to now cover, and then we have to put all the boards, private, no entry, private, no entry, etc. Because we have to protect ourselves, you see. So, and also these directions need no kshalana, no washing, and no shoshana, no drying. So no washing is necessary, no drying is necessary, etc. And it is not necessary that they wear any kind of bark or something. Earlier cave people, they used to wear tree bark, but that is also not necessary. Shaya Mahi. And earth is their bed. So Swamiji in his famous song of the Sannyasin, have you read it?
Yeah.
Song of the Sannyasin, he says, sky thy roof and food what chance may bring. Grass thy bed, sky thy roof and food what chance may bring. So that is the ideal of a Sannyasin. And Sancharo Nigamanta Vithishu. Nigama Anta means, Nigama means Vedas, Anta means end of Vedas or the essence of Vedas. So Nigama Anta means Vedanta. So they Sanchara, these men of realization, they move in the streets of Vedanta. They move in the streets. Viti means avenue or street. They move in the street of Vedanta. That means they always are thinking of such high thoughts, and Krida Pare Brahmani, and they always, their pastime is Supreme Brahman. Vimanam Alambhya Sharira Metat Bhunakti Asheshan Vishayan Upastitan Parechaya Balavat Atma Veta Yo Abhyakta Lingah Ananu Shakta Bahyah. So the person who is Atma Veta, who is the knower of Brahman, who has known Brahman, that person has no external mark outside. No external mark. Avyakta Lingaha. There is no external mark. Means it is difficult to understand such a person. So some person who has realized God, only that person will know that person has realized God. And all other people, they will not know. They will think that this is a mad Brahmin in Dakshineshwar, etc. So people used to say, mad Brahmin, he has got so many beddings, pillows, etc. And this person eats sweets and always eats and has always talks with people and is so fastidious in dress. He will wear all good dress, etc. So what kind of person? This is a fraud. That is what people used to talk about Sri Ramakrishna. So, why? Because avyakta lingaha, outside, external identification is not there. No identification, external identification is not there. Ananushakta bahyaha, he is not attached to external things. And vimanam alambya sharira metat. So, vimanam alambya sharira metat means, this body vimanam alambya sharinam etat. It is, the person is like on this body or rests on this body without any identification. If you take a flight, you are in the aircraft, in the aeroplane, and you don't identify yourself with the aeroplane. Though you are there in the aircraft, you don't identify yourself with the aircraft. So similarly, this person treats his body as aircraft, as a carrier, So having no identification with the body. Just like if you sit in a car, you don't get identified with the car. You know, I am sitting in the car, this will take me from one place to the other. Similarly, this person also does not identify with the body. And bhunakti aseshan vishayan. And this person experiences all vishayan, all sense objects as they come. Because that prarabdha karma, whatever results of actions have started taking effect in this life of that person, that those actions that person will enjoy or experience. And how? As and when they come, parechaya balavad, just like a child takes whatever somebody else gives, others wish. Somebody else gives something, that child takes, parechaya, not through one's own wish, but through others' wish. Similarly, this person also experiences sense objects which is given to that person by others. Digambaro vapi cha sambaro va twagambaro vapi chidambarastaha unmat vad vapi cha balavatva pishachavat vapi charantyavanyam. Digambaro vapi cha sambaro va. A person may, such a person who is realized, who has realized the ultimate reality, that person may be wearing clothes, sambara, or not wearing clothes. Digambara means having directions as one's clothes. Or chidambara, or that person may be wearing skins. Skins that person may be wearing. Or twagambara, or that person may sometimes wear clothes. So sometimes that person may wear clothes, sometimes that person may wear skins like deer skin, etc., or tree bark, etc., or sometimes that person may wear clothes. Unmattavat vapi, or that person may sometimes be like a mad person. Balavatva, or sometimes like a child. Pishachavatva, or sometimes like a ghoul, means not clean, etc. That person may be like that, like a pishacha. So in the scriptures it is told that a person who has realized Brahman lives like either balavat, unmattavat, pishachavat, either like a mad person or a child or a ghoul. Kamat nishkama rupi sancharet ekacharo munihi swatmanaiva sadatushtah swayam sarvatmana stitah. So the munihi, a sage who has ekacharo, who lives alone, that sage, one who has realized the Atman, lives alone, and kamat nishkama rupi sancharet. So that person is nishkama rupi. That person is the very embodiment of desirelessness. And swatmana eva sadatushtah, and is always satisfied by one's own self. Swayam sarvatmana stitah, and knows that that person is present in all. That person is present in all. And so that person experiences sense objects by having complete desirelessness. Now here again, many other qualities of a person who has realized the ultimate truth is being told. Kvachin moodah vidvan, kvachit abhi maharaja vibhavah, kvachit bhrantah saumyah, kvachit jagarachara kalitah, क्वचित पात्रीभूत क्वचित अवमत क्वाप्यविदितश्चरत्येव प्राज्ञः सतत परमानंद सुखितः. सो क्वचिन मूढ़ है. सो दिस पर्सन हु हैज रियलाइज्ड परमानंद सुखितः ऑलवेज हैप्पी विथ सुप्रीम ब्लिस परमानंद सुखितः सुप्रीम ब्लिस. दिस पर्सन इज लाइक व्हाट सतत परमानंद सुखितः ऑलवेज हैप्पी विथ सुप्रीम ब्लिस. प्राज्ञ है. One person who has realized the ultimate truth, that person is like what? Kochin Mudaha. Sometimes like a fool. Sometimes like a fool. So these are all impressions of a person who has not realized God. A person who has not realized God looks upon a person who has realized God like this. So to the world, the person who has realized God appears like this. But that person who has realized God, that person is always in that bliss, paramananda sukhitaha. But for other people, to other people, he or she appears like this. How? Kvachin mudaha, sometimes like a fool. Vidwan kvachidapi, sometimes like a vidwan or a knowledgeable person, wise person, sage. Then maharaja vibhavaha, sometimes like with royal splendor, like Raja something. Sometimes this person appears like that. Kvachit Bhranta. And sometimes like a person who is wandering. And sometimes Saumya. Sometimes that person is motionless. Kvachit Ajagara Achara Kalita. Means sometimes that person is motionless like a python. Like a python, that person is simply staying in one place or lying in one place. And sometimes saumya hai, means very calm, benign. Kvachit patri bhuta hai, sometimes that person is honored. Kvachit avamata hai, sometimes that person is insulted. Kva api avidita hai, sometimes that person is not known. Nobody knows about this person. And such is the way charati evam. That is how a person who has realized the ultimate truth lives. Nirdhano api sadatushtah api asahayo mahabalah nitya tripto api abhunjanah api asamah samadarshanah. So this person who has realized the ultimate reality is nirdhano api sadatushtah. Even though that person is without any wealth, nirdhana, सदा तुष्ट है, always satisfied. So now Rajesh may have 10 lakh rupees or 10 crore. हाँ, in his bank account 10 crore is there. 10 crore rupees. But 10 crore rupees also he is not happy. He still wants more and more money. He wants 1 crore. So Subramanyam ji may have say 50 crores. But he is still not happy. He wants another 10 crores. Give me another 10 crores. My daughter is there, no? Daughter is there. Now she has to be married off?
No.
No, she has to be married off. I saw the photograph with you in your WhatsApp. So she has to be married off. So at least 5 crores is necessary for marriage. You see, ordinary person's marriage means it is 50,000 rupees sufficient. Such person's daughter means 55 crores at least is necessary. So always money is necessary. Even then no satisfaction. But a person who has realized God, that person is nirdhanopi sadatushtah. Even if there is no money, that person is always satisfied. Asahayo mahabalah. Even though helpless, even then that person has got great strength. So you will see people who have complete dependence on God. Have you seen any people like that? Anybody who is completely dependent on God? Not seen. So that person, even though that person is very helpless, has nobody, alone, but that person will be very powerful. Means that person will not bother. Fearless. Nitya tripto api abhunjana hai. Abhunjana api nitya tripta hai. Even though that person is not experiencing sense objects, still the person is always satisfied. Now if he is going to get biryani every day, even then he will not be satisfied. He say, what is this? Every day you are giving biryani. such a horrible thing you are giving. So something. So then if you give khichdi, then you say, wow, today I had good food. What khichdi? Every day if you give khichdi, then you'll say, well, every day khichdi. So never satisfied, sense experience. And asamaha api samadarsana. Even though there is no comparison to such a person, that person will look on everybody with the same eye. Even though this person is incomparable, but still that person will look at everybody equally. Api kurvan akurvanah cha abhokta phalabhogyapi shariraapi ashariri esha parichinno api sarvagah. So though that person is engaged in activity, even then that person will be as though inactive. That person will be not disturbed. Though that person is experiencing phalabhoga of past actions, prarabdha karma, but that person is not touched by it. Though that person is shariri, the person has body, api ashariri esha, that person has no identification with the body. Parichinno api sarvagah, though that person is, you will not say that this is God realized person, where is God realized person? Everywhere. We don't say like that. One person will come and say, oh, this is God realized person. Even though that person is limited in a particular space, even then that person is omnipresent. That person does not identify oneself with only a particular body. Ashariram sadasantam imam brahma vidam kochit priya apriye nas prishatah tathaiva cha shubhashube. So that person, neither priya, pleasure, nor apriya, pain, touches that person. Neither shubha, good, ashubha, evil, sprishah, does not touch that person. Who? Brahma vidam kvachit. That person is how? Ashariram sadasantam. Always without a body idea. No sense of body. Body consciousness is not there. Sthuladi sambandavatah abhimaninah sukham cha dukham cha shubhashubhe cha vidvasta bandhasya sadatmano munehe kuta shubham va api ashubham phalam va. So for this person, sukham, pleasure or dukkham, pain, shubha, good or ashubha, evil, affects only such a person who is abhimaninah, identifying with sthuladi sambandavatah, with the connections of gross body. One who has connections with the gross body, sthula adi, sthula sharira, etc., means gross body, subtle body and causal body. Sthula, sukshma, karna sharira. A person who identifies with that and gets connected with that, only that person is affected by vidvasta. That person is affected by this pleasure, pain, good and evil. But a person, sadatmano munehe, a person who is always identifying oneself with the reality, vidvasta bandhasya, and one who has destroyed bondage, shattered bondage, how can that person, kuta shubham vapi shubham ashubham phalam va, how can that person have good or evil or their effects, how can that person be affected by these? So only a person who is connected with the bodies, gross, subtle and causal bodies, can be affected by good and bad, pleasure and pain. Not a person.
What do we mean by sukshma sharira and karna sharira?
Karna sharira means ignorance and sukshma sharira means antakarana. Antakarana means this chitta, buddhi, man, ahankar. All this. Tamasa grastavat bhanat agrasto api ravir janaihi grasta ityuchyate bhrantyam hi ajnyatva vastu lakshanam. So you see, when we see eclipse, we say that the sun is now being swallowed by Rahu. We say that sun is being now swallowed by Rahu. Actually it is solar eclipse, but in our Puranas we have this. So tamasa grastavat bhanat agrasto api ravir janaihi. But actually it is not swallowed. It appears to be swallowed. Similarly in eclipse also, sun is not covered. It, because of this moon coming, it appears as though sun is covered, but sun is there in where it is there. It is because of tamasa, because of delusion, that we think bhrantiyam, because of delusion we think that it is being swallowed. Similarly, grastha ityuchyate, everybody says that it has been swallowed, grastha. Similarly, ajnyatva vastu lakshanam, without knowing the real nature of sun. What is the real nature of sun? It is full of light, mass of light, so it cannot be swallowed. So without knowing the real nature of sun, we say that it is being swallowed. Tadvat dehadi bandhebhyo vimuktam brahma vittamam pashyanti dehivat mudaha sharira abhasa darshanat. Similarly, mudaha, ignorant people, they look upon the brahma vittamam, the knower of Brahman, means a person who is the ultimate knower of Brahman, perfect knower of Brahman. They look upon such a person who has dehadi bandhebhyo vimuktam, who is completely free from bondages of body, etc. That person people look at and say, dehi vat pashyanti. They think that this person has got body. Sarira abhasa darshanat. Sharira abhasa darshanat. Because that person has an appearance of body, these people think, oh, you also have a body. This person also has a body. Ahi nirvalyavenim vayam muktva deham tutishtati itaha tataha chalyamano yat kinchit pranavayuna. So, just like the body, it gives up its body of the snake. It gives up its skin, sheds its skin. But that skin, it remains. Suppose the skin of a snake is there. You see, snake sheds its skin. So when it sheds its skin, it goes away. So if you go and see the skin, it will appear as though there is snake. But it is not snake, it's just the skin of the snake. And similarly, a person who has realized God, that person discards one body, means does not identify oneself with the body. And that is just like that. That is just lying there. Body is lying there. And the body moves here and there by pranavayuna, by the vital energy of the body. So that person is not identifying. Just like a snake does not identify with the skin it has already shed, a person who has realized the ultimate Brahman does not identify with the body. Stotrasa strotasa niyate daru yatha nimna unnata sthalam daivena niyate deho yatha kala upabuktishu. See, what happens is, in hill regions, or usually in hill regions, they used to transport wood by putting it in river. So if you put river wood in the river of high altitude, in its current it will go down. Even in these areas, hill regions in Himalayas, they used to transfer wood like that. That is why Kat Godam. You see, Kat Godam is the place where they used to collect. Kat means wood, Godam means godown. They used to collect all the wood and store. And from there they used to transport it to all over the country. All these good wood is available in forests here, in Himalayan forests. So, strotasa niyate daru, just like the current of river will take daru, wood. Yatha nimna unnata sthalam, from a unnata sthalam, from a high ground to low ground. Similarly, daivena niyate dehah, the person who has realized God, that person's body is carried on by past actions. Daivena, by the effect of past actions. And yatha kala upabhaktishu, and whatever just like the wood comes and wherever it goes, in the river, it will go automatically. Similarly, this person will get whatever experience comes to that person. It will come in the course of the prarabdha karma. Prarabdha karma parikalpita vasanabhihi sansarivat charati bhuktishu mukta dehaha siddha swayam vasati sakshivat atra tushnim chakrasya moolamiva kalpa vikalpa shunyaha. The person who has realized Atman, that person, Siddha, that person, without any mukta deha, without any idea of body, without any identification with body, sansarivat charati bhuktishu, moves in sense or in experiences or enjoyment, just like a person who has not realized God, just like a person who is bound. Sansarivat, just like a sansari, a person who is constantly taking birth and death. So a person who has realized God also moves just like a sansari in this. Prarabdha karma parikalpita vasanabhihi. And how? By vasanas, desires which are created by prarabdha karma. And swayam vasati shakshivat. But that person, however, lives like a witness. Tushneem. Without any disturbance. Chakrasya moolameva. Just like you have this potter's wheel, chakra. Potter's wheel or any other chakra, even in bullock cart or something, even in our automobiles, we have this wheel. So there is a pivot for that wheel. The pivot does not move. Only the wheel moves. Okay, pivot is in one place. So similarly, this person also is completely undisturbed by all these experiences and without any vikalpa shunya, without any mental disturbances, that person, like sakshi, like a witness, remains. Om shanti 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 hari om tat sat.